What's going on, guys? Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to Amigoscode. In this video, I want to discuss with you why you should never start with microservices when building applications. So this is something that I've seen a lot of people doing, and that is they are applying for jobs or they are complete beginners and they want to learn pretty much everything because the job spec says that you need to know about microservices, you need to know about AWS, you need to know about X, you need to know about Y, you need to know about basically the whole world, and you just kind of freak out and then you go and basically try and learn everything. Now, this is literally wrong. And in fact, recently, I think it was last week, Amazon Prime, they wrote an article how they switch from serverless, so microservices architecture, to a monolithic architecture, which is like mind-blowing. They saved, I think, over 90% of their AWS bill, which is like crazy. So what is microservices, right? So let's first understand microservices. So microservices is this idea where you kind of have little fine-grained services that do one and only one thing and well. And then you basically have microservices. So if microservices A, you know, let's say sends emails, for example, that's its only job. And then you've got microservice B that basically performs customer registration. You have microservice C, which performs authentication. Then you can basically talk to each other via HTTP, right? So this is one way of building microservices. Here, the benefit is that they're very small. Each team owns the microservice. You can choose literally whatever language you want and whether you want to adopt serverless or not. So the possibilities here are huge, right? And with this, in most cases, you are able to scale. So if you look at this diagram here, so this is an example of microservices. So basically, this is part of my microservices course, which you can find on the website. But basically, you can see that, you know, I've got a couple of microservices. When they want to talk to each other, there's a message queue. Each of these microservices, they have their own databases. Then they also pull Docker images from the registry, config server for configuration and tracing. And you can see that, you know, this is quite intense. You know, if you are building an application from scratch, do you think it makes sense for you to use microservices? Come on. Yes or no? Absolutely no. So there's no need for you to build your application if you're starting from the ground using microservices, because the complexity involved building all of this is quite huge for something that is very small. You don't know whether the application will scale. You don't know whether the application will make its way to the market, for example, right? So you don't know how many users will consume the application. So all of those unknowns, like, why would you put so much effort in terms of learning microservices just for the sake of learning microservices? Now, the reason why I was able to learn microservices is because I came from a monolithic background, and back then I actually saw all the issues, right? So my team, actually, we started to encounter issues where, you know, deployments, you know, were taking long time. Basically, if I wanted to release a feature, right, I would need to take basically the whole world, right? And that wasn't great. It would take a long time for us to release. And in terms of scaling, it was a bottleneck for us. And that's when we decided to switch to microservice. Now, we basically started with monolithic, and then gradually we started encountering issues. And then we said, right, so what is the best way for us to solve the issues that we are facing right now? And microservices were the solution for us, right? So at that point, we had to think, okay, so team A will own microservice A, B, and C, for example, or team B will own microservice D, X, Y, Z, for example, right? So at that point, that was basically the turning point for us to switch to microservice. So for you, I would say the benefit of learning microservice from the beginning, literally, there's no benefit, okay? So start with a monolithic architecture, right? So basically go from this in here to this, right? So this, you can see that this diagram here is way simpler than the other one. And basically, if you're deploying this to production, you've got a load balancer, and then basically you've got, you know, replicas of your application. So here you could basically have multiple business functions within the application. That's fine, provided that it is very small and they all talk to one database instead of having to manage multiple databases, right? So this is nice and simple for you to learn. And at this point, you can then start to encounter issues as things scale, right? So, you know, if releases are taking long enough for you to perform, then you need to solve that issue. Then if you're not scaling well enough, then you need to solve that issue. Then if you need to introduce a message queue, introduce a message queue. But basically, don't just think that microservice is the solution, because it's not always the solution. And there's this misconception that people say, oh, the monolithic, it's old technology. What is so old about this? There's nothing old about this, right? So you could use whatever language you want. You could use whatever framework you want. You could use pretty much anything you want to build this, right? So provided that you are serving your customers with a system that actually works without complexity that even yourself, you can't even manage, right? So I would rather have a system that works really well. It's easy to manage, right? So, you know, developers, we don't like things that are complicated, right? So we opt always for the simplest solution, okay? Provided that it makes sense, okay? But this architecture here, as you start development, it's the best approach for you and also as a beginner, because you learn a bunch from this, right? So your understanding will be way better if you start with monolithic and then transition to microservices. And in fact, so our course, so here on the website, so this is the full stack professional, which is, I think it's around 70 hours. And currently we have a 1 year JetBrains whole product pack license worth $700. So go and check it out. But basically, it's more than 50 hours now. But here we go from the ground up in terms of how to build a full stack application, right? And you'll see that the entire process. And the goal really is that towards the end, I'll introduce you to everything that you need to know in terms of start thinking, right? So, oh, okay, so now microservices, it does make sense. So I would need to use microservice because of XYZ, okay? So this is a video that I wanted to get out because, you know, sometimes people think, oh, I need to learn microservice, and they completely forget about monolithic. And, you know, you just saw that Amazon Prime, they went from microservices architecture to monolithic. Let me know, are you using monolithic right now, or microservice, or literally just comment down below and let me know your thoughts on this, right? Should you start with microservices? Yes or no? This is pretty much it. Don't forget to subscribe, smash the like button, and I'll see you on the next one. Assalamu alaikum.